Today we'll be seeing experiment 4 of basic electrical engineering laboratory. The experiment titles is two-way and three-way control of lamp and formation of a truth table. Before we get into what is two-way and what is three-way, we'll see how a one-way control of switch looks like. That is, you have one switch and one lamp. Switching on or off of this switch will control this lamp is called one-way control of lamp. Again, when you come to a one-way control of lamp, you'll have only two terminals. I'll call this as common in and common out. Coming back to a two-way control switch, as the name says, you have two switches and the terminal now will be, you'll have three terminals. So this is two switches and three terminals. So one terminal will be common in and the other terminal will be 1-1 dash. For the next switch, it will be 2-2 dash and common out. Here, for these two switches to operate or to control one lamp, the above terminals, which is 1-2, should be connected in series and 1-2 should be connected in series. So this is how a two-way control circuit looks like. As a title says, you have to form a truth table. To form a truth table, we have to consider different positions of switch S1 and different positions of switch S2. So that is at switch S1 at position 1 or switch S1 at position 2. So we'll form a truth table for it. Coming back here, I have written different combinations for this. When switch S1 is at 1 and switch S2 is at 2, so that is switch S1 is at 1 and switch S2 is at 2, we'll see whether the lamp is on or off. So as I switch on the supply, the current passes through this point, it completes this path from 1 to 2 and then leaves out common out and comes back to lamp. From lamp, it reaches the neutral. So you see a closed path here. That means at 1 and 2, the status of the lamp is on. Again, coming back to 1- and 2-. So again, the supply starts from here. It moves from 1- to 2-, leaves 2-, and then comes back to lamp. So again, you see a closed path. So at 1- and 2-, it is on. For the next combination, which is 1-9-2-, we'll see how it works. So here again, a supply starts from L, moves to 1, and then 1 to 2. After 2, there is no path for this current to move into the circuit. That means it is an open circuit. At open circuit condition, the lamp never operates. So that is at 1-2-, it is off. Similarly, you can write it for 1-2 as off. So this is how I form a truth table for a two-way control switch. Now we'll see how does a three-way control switch looks like. Again, as again the name says, it is three-way control. That is, one lamp is controlled by three switches. All I have to do is I have to draw three switches, and now the middle switch is called as, the third switch is called intermediate switch. And it will have four terminals like this. I will name it as A, B, C, D. Again, two two-way switches. So this will be 1-1 and 2-2. Again, you have a contact. Either it will be pointing 1 or this will be pointing 2- or 2. So now again, for all these three lamps to control, all these three switches to control one lamp, I have to connect all the above ends in series, that is 1 to A, A to B, and B to 2. So this is how it looks like. Now, before getting into how this three-way control of lamp works, we'll see how does this intermediate switch work. Intermediate switch is just a switch of four terminals. When, and this has two combinations, that is, it can also act as a straight connection and also act as cross connection. We'll see how does it. So we already know intermediate switch will have four terminals, which is A, B, C, D. When this switch is at off condition, the terminal A will be connected to terminal B and the terminal C will be connected to terminal D. As this is looking like a straight line, I'll call this as a straight connection. And again, coming back to cross connection, that is, when I switch on the intermediate switch, the contacts which are like this gets interchanged or crisscross. That is, A gets connected to D and C gets connected to B. So this is how intermediate switch looks under on off condition and on condition. We have to form a truth table for both straight connection and a truth table for cross connection. Okay. So coming back to the straight connection, I said a straight connection will always have A, B connected, C, D connected. Now we'll see at the position of switch S1 at 1, position of switch S2 at 2, under straight connection, we'll see how does it work. So again, coming back, the supply starts from here. It moves from common into 1, and then from 1 to A to B, and then B to 2, it comes back to the lamp. From lamp, it leads to the neutral. So this is again a closed circuit. So you'll have at 1 and 2 condition, it is on again. And then similarly for 1 dash and 2 dash, you can see it is on. Going back to this 1 and 2 dash condition, so that is, this is at 1 and this is at, this is at 1 and this is at 2 dash. Again, we'll start. The supply flows in like this. It comes back to 1, 1 to A to B, and from B to 2. Again, there is no path for the current to flow back to this lamp. So you will see at 1 and 2 condition, 2 dash condition, it is off. Again, similarly, you can write it at 1 dash and 2, it is off. So this is about a three-way control of lamp under straight connection. Now we'll see how does a three-way control of lamp happen under cross connection. So again, cross is nothing but me connecting a connection in a crisscross direction, that is A to D, C to B. So forming a truth table again, this is at switch S1 at 1 and switch S2 at 2, that is switch S1 at 1 and switch S2 at 2. We'll start again. When the supply is on, the current travels from here, moves into 1, 1 to A and A to D. After D, it comes to 2 dash, and at 2 dash, there is no path for current to complete. So here, that is why the supply is off. That is, the lamp is off. Again, we'll see, that is the same. You can similarly, you can write it for 1 dash and 2 dash too. At condition 1 dash and 2 dash, you will see lamp is off. For this 1 and 2 dash, that is, or I can write it as 1 dash and 2. So I'll write for this combination. So it is, the supply starts from here, it comes back to 1 dash, travels to C to D, B to 2, and then from 2 it goes back to the lamp, from lamp it goes back to neutral. That is, there is a closed path. So that is why at 1 dash and 2 you will have lamp at on, and 1 and 2 dash you will have it on. So this is about how we form a truth table, how we write a circuit diagram for it. We have to conduct practically and see if this formation of truth table stays true or not. So again, to begin the experiment, To begin with, we have this circuit connection. Now, this apparatus requires two switches to do a two-way control. We require two switches, one lamp and a supply port. You can come back and see here. You have two switches and a supply and a lamp. So we'll see how is it connected. Here, the supply line is connected to common in of this switch S1. So here, this is my L supply. I will give it to the common in of switch S1, and then 1 is connected to 2. Again, 1 is connected to 2. Coming back, common out of the switch S2 is connected to one end of the lamp. So common out of the switch is connected to one end of the lamp, and lamp at the other end of the lamp is connected to neutral. So the other end of the lamp, let's come back to neutral. So only this is left. So again, coming back, 1 dash is connected to 2 dash. So here I connect 1 dash to 2 dash. This is a simple arrangement to show you how a two-way control switch works. Now we can see, as per the truth table being formed already, at 1 and 2 condition, you have to see the lamp should be on. That is, you can come back and see here. At 1 and 2, that is, a lamp should be on. That is, at 1 and 2, the lamp is on. Coming back to the
true table again at 1 and 2 dash the lamp should be off. That is at 1 and 2 dash you can see that the lamp is off. We'll see the other combination 1 dash and 2 again the lamp should be off. That is 1 dash and 2 the lamp should be off. The last combination will be 1 dash and 2 dash the lamp should be on. So this is 1 dash, it's already at 1 dash and this is at 2 dash the lamp is on. So this is how I verify, this is how I form a truth table and verify it through a conduction. So this is a verification of two-way control. Now before we start we'll switch off the supply again for three-way control. Now again remove the connections. So here a three you can see the circuit here. So this is a three-way control switch, that is you should have two-way control switches and one intermediate switch which has four terminals in it, and you need a lamp and you require a supply. So here one end of the supply is connected to common in of the switch S1. So one end of L is connected to common in of switch S1, and again one is again connected to terminal A. If I can write it here as A, B, C and D, so it is one is connected to A, so this is my one, I connected to A, and then B to S2, so this is my B and this I connected to S2. Again common out should be connected to lamp, so this common out will be connected to one end of the lamp. The other end of the lamp comes back to neutral, so this end of the lamp comes back to neutral. So this is about, we have completed the first the above part of the circuit. Now all you have to do is connect 1 dash to C. So this is 1 dash to C, and then D to 2 dash. So this is how I a circuit for three-way control looks like. Now we have to verify how it operates under straight connection and how it operates under cross connection. So we already have written a truth table for this. All you have to do is under straight connection you have to check if at 1 and 2 whether the lamp is on or not. So I'll switch on the supply. At 1 and 2 it is already at 2. So at 1 and 2 you can see that the lamp is on. Again at 1 and 2 dash the lamp should be off. So at 1 and 2 dash the lamp should be off. Similarly you can verify for the other conditions. At 1 dash and 2 dash you will see again off. That is at 1 dash and 2 you will see the lamp is off. At the end 1 dash and 2 dash you will see the lamp is on. So at 1 dash and 2 dash the lamp is on. Now I verify 3-way control for straight connection. The other, now again we have to verify for cross connection. At cross connection, that is the terminal A will be connected to terminal D and terminal C will be connected to terminal B. All I have to do is I just have to press a switch. Once I press a switch, again we'll check for this cross connection. Now at 1 and 2 you have to see the lamp is, lamp should be off. At 1 and 2 the lamp is off. And 1 and 2 dash you have to see lamp is on. So at 1 and 2 dash the lamp should be on. Again coming back, we'll just see this last combination, which is 1 dash and 2. At 1 dash and this is at 2, you have to see lamp is on. So I verify the truth table for two-way control. Now I also verified truth table for straight connection and then a cross connection. So we can write the result as the truth table of two-way and three-way control of lamps have been formed and verified. So this is how we complete the circuit. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day.